Everybody, it's Invicta, and I wanted to make another tier list video. Thank you, everybody, for the support on the first tier list with the Isaac Bosses tier list. That one was a lot of fun, created a lot of neat discussion on Reddit, as well as in the comments as well. Obviously, as a quick disclaimer for these type of videos, it is going to be opinionated. These are going to be based on my own recommendations, my own feelings about certain items, and today we've got ourselves a doozy of a list. I'm going to be ranking every single spacebar item in Rebirth, Afterbirth, and Afterbirth Plus. Shout out to, first off, tiermaker.com for hosting this list, and also to Odlin, who is a member of the Mosh Pit here on Twitch, who made this tier list. I requested it at the end of the creation of the boss tier list video that you all saw a couple days ago. For somebody, if they wanted to save me the time to do so, I wanted to do the spacebar items next, and Odlin from the Twitch TV Mosh Pit was very kind enough to do this. It took a lot of hours, I'm sure, so thank you very much to Odlin for doing it. Here we go. So really quickly, as another disclaimer here, there is a bottom tier, but as with the boss list, which I guess I didn't really communicate clear enough, as with the boss list, the bottom tier does not mean that it is the absolute worst tier, all right? It's on its own separate tier based on a couple of different criteria. For this one in particular, we have situationally amazing, but also reroll items. Now, I'm not going to lie, I did record a spacebar tier list video earlier in this week, but I wasn't happy with it because the D4 and the D100 especially caused a little bit of issues with my own feelings. I put it on S rank, but they're not quite S rank, so that's why I made it for the separate reroll items, because there's some times where you're not going to use the reroll items at all. It doesn't mean they're bad, but it also doesn't mean they're good. So that's the reason why I'm sort of deviating from just the regular old ranking, and I'm saying situationally amazing. These are going to be items that are incredible if you need to use them, but if not, then they're probably not going to have that much value. So I just want to get that out of there right now. So you can go ahead and start. We can start with the D100, the D100, the D4. Both of those are going to be in there because of the fact that they re-roll your character. Now, that being said, I'm not going to put stuff like the D20 and the D6 in there because you're not forced to use those, and they're not as game-breaking or as game-changing as something like re-rolling your character total. So that's the reason why the D100 and the D4 are extremely good items if you need to use them. Otherwise, they're not really all that great. So, or they can be completely useless or a non-factor. So without further ado, I'm going to try to not dwell on these items very long, because the first time that I made this video was over an hour long. So I'm going to be flying through these. I'll try to go with a little bit more of the more controversial placings in there as I get there. Hopefully most people will agree with it, but probably not. Again, that's the essence of the tier maker fad right now. And again, shout out to Odlin for making this tier list. If you want to make your own version of the spacebar list, I'll be putting a link down below to the tier maker video, or to the tier maker list that Odlin put together, so you can make your own and then you can compare it with your friends and all that kind of good stuff. So let us get started. IV bag, you're able to create money out of your HP. Immediately goes up to A rank for me. It's not S tier because it's not something that you're always going to be using, but it is something that you should be using if you need money and if you have the red hearts. Now, I know that you could be saying this is situationally amazing, which it is, but also you have to consider that the IV bag also, it synergizes with other great items, such as with Samson's Lock. You have it with Bloody Lust. And basically anything that makes you take damage, it can be go with Gimpy as well. So the IV bag is a good start here for this list because it sort of sets the baseline of what is useful, but also better than situationally amazing. I love the IV bag. You don't have to use it, but if you can, it can give you a multitude of benefits. Super good. Forget Me Now resets the floor. Situationally amazing. If you need to use it, great. You can use it to game the system to get an extra devil deal, all that kind of good stuff. But more importantly, if you need to reset, if you didn't get the item that you wanted from the boss room or even the item room, it gives you an extra item for both of those rooms. So you're giving yourself more outs. And that's why Forget Me Now is not an automatic use, because there's sometimes you don't want to reroll a run, or if you're just going for boss rush or something like that, or not reroll run, but restart a room or a floor, then you don't have to use it. But Forget Me Now is a good item. If you need to use it, great. If not, no big deal. Flying Pony. I do love me the Flying Pony. It gives you flying, it gives you movement speed, it gives you a little bit of a dash attack. It has a relatively short cooldown. It's not a great item, but it's certainly not terrible. It's if you need flying and you need 1.5 movement speed, it's pretty ubiquitous when it's found across basically the entire game. You can find it outside of having it from Conquest. So Flying Pony, good item, not great, but also not terrible either. My Best Friend. I like My Best Friend. If you need a makeshift Mr. Mega Bomb, then look no further. It also, of course, draws aggro, so again, it sort of presents itself as a, do we need to use this, or does this take place of something else that has value that we don't currently possess? That's exactly what a free bomb does. Same thing goes really for Bob's Rotten Head as well. Sort of the optional bomb items that you're able to use whenever you need to, or you can use it for offense, are very, very good. Again, I wouldn't say that they're amazing items, because obviously you can do the same thing with just a regular bomb, which is the reason why I'm not going to put them any higher than B. But middle of the road, if you need to use them, they're there. They provide good utility. Not too bad. Blood Rite, situationally amazing. Of course, the only time that I can ever see me realistically using Blood Rite is when you have Isaac's Heart. Other than that, it's a pretty niche item. It's not really something that I'm going to be able to rank fairly against other items, mainly because of the fact that I just don't... I hardly ever run into Blood Rites, but I also don't ever... Even if I get the chance to use Blood Rites with Isaac's Heart, I'm not going to really utilize it all that much. So it's situationally amazing at best, but it's not that great. But it's not trash, it's just not that great. You can use it however you want, if it makes sense. Blank Card, our first S rank item of the entire list here. Blank Card, you know what it does, you love it, you need it. If you want to duplicate a card, to duplicate a rune, anything like that, the Blank Card's got you covered. I mean, what else can you say about it? It's a very versatile spacebar item. It's found across a lot of loot tables, and it's very, very common in the store as well. Super item, S rank all the way. Anarchist Cookbook. Not a fan of the Anarchist Cookbook. The only thing that it does, of course, if you have the safety scissors or something like that, it gives you free bombs. Other than that, it's not situationally amazing either, because the bombs are just too random. Even if you do commit to the idea of using the Anarchist Cookbook as offense, it doesn't mean that you're going to get guaranteed damage at all, or if any damage, on your target. It's just too erratic with the way that the tower bombs come in, and overall, not a great item. Use it if you want, but there's way better items out there. Same thing goes for the poop as well. You do have some synergies with the poop and Midas Touch, that sort of stuff, but on the whole, the poop is just not a good item. It's what Blue Baby starts with. Maybe you can get lucky and get a little bit of consumables out of that. Maybe if you have a good synergy with the Midas Touch, sure, it could be situationally amazing, but there's still just other better items out there, in my opinion. C rank is where the poop goes, and that's where it shall stay. Book of Revelations, almost S rank. I'm going to put it on the A rank, however, because there are certain moments where you either don't need an orbital or you don't want an orbital. Depending on what kind of orbitals you already have, you're not going to be able to overwrite them, or maybe you do not want to overwrite them. Of course, the bigger reason why you would want to take the Book of Revelations is that it does give you a soul heart. I'm not exactly sure if you want to say that it's S rank, though, because there are, again, situations where you don't want to be fighting a horseman. With the way that the Book of Revelations influences whether or not you're going to run into a horseman boss or not, sometimes you might say, hey, I don't need a cube of meat. I already got, like, meat boy or whatever. I need a boss item. I need an HP upgrade. I need a damage upgrade, something like that. If you use the Book of Revelations, there's a chance that you're not going to get it on the oddly floored items or oddly floored floors. So in certain situations, the Book of Revelations can be extremely useful. Other situations, it's not that useful, but still, giving yourself a soul heart generator is very strong indeed. Not quite S rank because of the situational thing, but it's certainly not a trash item either. Lemon Mishap, I really want to put this on B rank, but C rank is where it should go. The radius isn't as good as you would like it to be, and the damage is not all that great, plus it doesn't hit flying enemies. Crack the Skizzle, Crack the Sky, A rank or S rank. It's so, so tempting for me to put this on S rank, but I can't really do so, just because there is a chance that the Crack the Sky beams will not kill, just flat out kill the bosses. But other than that, I mean, Crack the Sky is an amazing item. Super low cooldown, very common to see, is very common start item as well. If you're going for the, if you're looking on Eden Streak or Eden Start like that, you usually see Crack the Sky in the item room. It's just a very good overall item. It's almost S rank. If there was a borderline S rank, that's what Crack the Sky would be. Very strong, good with homing. Yeah, it's a good item. So, how to jump? I want to say situationally amazing. I want to say B rank as well, but it's hard for me to do so. It's difficult for me to put it on C rank. I mean, is how to jump, you know, as good or as bad as the poop? No, it's slightly better. Is it better than these items over here? I would say probably not. So B tier it is. I almost want to put it situationally amazing, though. If you don't have flying, or if you find like a library or something that you can find the jump cartridge and jump over those blocks, of course you can get those items for free. But more importantly, the iframes or the damage mitigation, the active damage mitigation that you get from the jump cartridge is very, very powerful. I do like it. It's not a trash item. It's better than situationally amazing, but it's not as good as the A rank. Ventricle Razor, there's no real good use for it. You can get out of boss rushes, you can get out of like trap rooms, that sort of thing. Of course, there's a very well-known exploit that you can do with blood banks. I'm not going to talk about it because you never see me do it because I don't like to use exploits. But overall, Ventricle Razor, outside of just having a fool card, that's really all it's good for. I mean, yeah, it's nice to be able to get out of challenge room, but other than that, it just does not really ring a bell with me. It's okay, but there's way better. Doctor's Remote, got to put on the B tier. It's very strong. Again, along the lines with My Best Friend, along with the Bob's Rotten Head, having the Doctor's Remote, having an on-call epic fetus shot every other room is very, very strong, especially if you can get it combined with a 9-volt or with trickle charge, something like that. It does deal a very good amount of damage to bosses, and yeah, it's not too bad. Not terrible, not great. Middle of the road. Soul Converter, I almost want to put this in Situationally Amazing. In fact, I originally did put it on the first iteration of this list, but I am going to put it on the C rank just because even me knowing that I might get Guppy's Paw, or even if I've had Guppy's Paw, you've seen it in the Eden Streak before, I don't ever really utilize the Soul Converter. If you want to take, if you're like just looking for a super cheap devil deal and you have a plethora of soul hearts, then sure, go ahead and use it. But other than that, it's an item that almost everybody just rerolls past. There is a way to get infinite health. You can do a little bit of shenaniganery with Guppy's Paw and with the Soul Converter, but that's only if you have Guppy's Paw, and even then it's not super duper amazing. So Soul Converter, it's a good idea, not one I use. Game Kid's not too bad. I would put it on the C tier, except for the fact that it does give you heals along with the invincibility. Only thing I really don't like, and this is a huge negative mark for me on the Game Kid, is that it fears enemies for the duration of the invincibility stage, or phase, I should say. So while it is nice to be able to destroy stuff with the Game Kid, and it's nice to give you red heart healing, there's sometimes that maybe you don't even want to heal for red hearts. So again, situationally, it's better than that, but it's not a trash item either. Of course, you can use it in arcades, you can use it for demon judgments, that sort of thing. But overall, it's just a middle-of-the-road item. Not great, not terrible. It's okay. The Book of Secrets. It's hard for me to put this on the B tier, but I'm going to, only because there's other books that are just way better out there. But the Book of Secrets is very good. It is sort of like your pseudo treasure map, your pseudo compass, that sort of stuff. It can be very good, but again, you don't really have any control over it and over what it shows you. Sometimes you get the blue map effect. Sometimes you get the treasure map effect, like 3 in a row. Sometimes you get the full map effect. It's very, very nice. But overall, it's middle of the road. If you have it, great. But there's other things. Even in the B tier, there's other items that you're going to be using over the Book of Secrets. Crystal Ball, get up there, S rank. You knew it was going to happen. Crystal Ball gives you the map compass effect. It gives you a soul heart, and it can even give you a tarot card or a rune. What more would you want from a space bar item? Crystal Ball, the only bad thing is that it's super duper rare, and of course, if Curse of Loss comes over, then half of its power is gone. But having the Crystal Ball is super duper top tier, without question going to be an S rank item. If you see it, you take it. At least that's how I am. If I see it, I take it. Crystal Ball, S tier, god item, love it. Trinket Smelter, definitely have to put it on the A rank, almost S rank, I would say. This is really another borderline between A and S. Trust me, the step down from A rank, from S rank to A rank is not that significant. So anything that's located A and above is top tier elite level items. It's just that there's a sub tier in those elite items that say, hey, every time I see this, I'm taking it no matter what. Versus with the Trinket Smelter, maybe you find it inside of a late game shop, or you find it in the Hush shop. Especially if you don't have a good trinket or multiple trinkets, then this Trinket Smelter doesn't really have a whole lot of value. You could even argue it could be situationally amazing. I think the Smelter is a little bit better than that. Of course, it does give you the ability to have a trinket as a passive item, so that alone gives more value to stuff that doesn't have value, and that's a big part of my criteria on how I rank this. Trinket Smelter, awesome item, super duper happy with it being A rank. Teleport 2.0, you knew it was coming, get on up there, S rank. Look, if I'm known for signature items, the Teleport 2.0, I'm very happy to have that as one of my signature items that my following knows. I love Teleport 2.0. Not only can get you guaranteed devil deals, it can even get you guaranteed error rooms. Super awesome. And if you don't know, if you're not very good at finding the secret rooms, the super secret rooms, then hey, all you gotta do is find a full charge on the ground, baby. Or even in the shop. And it takes you to the super secret room and regular secret room. It's so good. It's better than what you may think, because not only does it give you access to those extra rooms, but you're giving yourself more opportunities to win. Not a whole lot of spacebar items can say that, except Teleport 2.0 and a handful of others. S rank all the way. I don't care. I will argue anyone about that. Teleport 2.0 is the best item you're not using correctly. Black Hole, going to put it on the B rank here. You could borderline C rank it, but I think it's a little bit better than B rank just because of the fact that it does destroy rocks kind of like a bomb. It deals damage. It does crowd control. It's a very good item. The damage it does is somewhat negligible, but it's more useful, in my opinion anyway, it's more useful as a block destroyer, an enemy, or a utility item grabber, a consumable grabber, that sort of thing. So Black Hole, it does deal decent damage. It's certainly not terrible, but it's also not great. Middle of the road, duper duper. Wooden Nickel, I almost want to say Situation of the Maze Amp, but I am going to put it on the C rank here. There's just other better items out there. It is nice that it does not have a cooldown. Whenever you have, like, say, 9 volt or something like that, it will recharge itself. And, of course, it's what the Keeper starts with. So, situationally, if you're the Keeper, then, yeah, of course, you want to stick with the Wooden Nickel almost at all times. But there are other items out there. Overall, we're talking about the general scope of an item. I hardly ever see... find myself saying, oh man, look, it's the Wooden Nickel. We got to take that over Doctor's Remote. No, you're not going to have that. So the D5 or D7, it's a reroll item, but this one doesn't really do a whole lot. I mean, the problem that I have with, like, rerolling rocks, rerolling enemies and that sort of thing is that it's just too random and I never ever use them, because you can actually create a situation where it's going to be worse for it, you can actually make the room that you're in worse, if that makes sense. So the only one that makes the only space for item that I'm okay with saying, hey, by the way, you know, sometimes we use this. It is nice to have the D10 to be able to reroll all of the the rocks inside of a room, that sort of thing. Again, you can give yourself sort of like a, if you're lucky, you can give yourself like a tinted rock. You can give yourself a bomb rock. Maybe that gives you something better than what you got. I mean, there's not a whole lot I can really say, but really the D7, the D10, yeah. I mean, this the D10 is what we're looking at right now. So rerolling enemies, rerolling the rocks, it's okay, but it's not great. You're gonna find other ways. It's not as good situationally either. So the D12 is the one that rerolls the rocks, by the way. So where is the D12? I'll go ahead and get this one out of the way right now. So yeah, I mean, situationally it can be good, but there's just no way that you can control it. Yeah, so that's my argument on that. The Sprinkler, holy smokes, it could potentially be S rank, but it could also potentially be terrible. I'm putting it down here in situationally amazing only because of the fact that the Sprinkler is heavily dependent on what kind of tiers you have. I recently had a Cricket's Body Jacob's Ladder Tech Zero run where I also had I picked up the Sprinkler late game and it just plowed through everything. And of course, if you have a way to recharge your space bar item, you can get multiple sprinklers. So if it's worth it to you and you have the extra energy to do so, the Sprinkler can be a godly, maybe even like above S tier, because it's going to waste anything in the room. But I can't really say by itself it's very good. That's why I'm putting it situationally amazing. Hopefully that would make sense. So, pause or hold or Neo, whatever you want to call this item, it's not an item that I really use ever. I mean, if you want to catch projectiles, you can, I guess, if you want to, but I personally have never used the item the way that's intended. Telekinesis is just kind of, the only thing nice about it is that it does have a recharge time, a relatively low recharge time, and you can throw the projectiles away from it, but it's cumbersome to use. It doesn't save you all that much damage, and it doesn't deal that much damage either. So if you like telekinesis, put it above, sure. But for me personally, I never ever use the item. Yeah. Monster Manual. Again, the only good thing about Monster Manual is the fact that if you need an achievement for the four levels of Meat Boy or Bandage Girl, you can use it with like Nun's Habit or Sharp Plug. Other than that, you're just using it for the Bookworm transformation. Yeah. So, My Little Unicorn. So hard for me to put this on the B rank, which is why I'm gonna put it in the A rank, because it's better if you took My Little Unicorn and Game Kid, and you say which one are you gonna always take? Everyone's gonna go for My Little Unicorn. It deals amazing amounts of damage. It gives you invincibility, and on top of that, it does not fear enemies, and that's the big thing for me, because I like to be able to control the enemies. I like to be able to control where my damage is going, and that's exactly what My Little Unicorn does. It gives you that versatility while still having that invincibility power to keep you safe and deal damage to bosses. Good item, better than Game Kid. Mystery gift. It's hard for me to put this anywhere other than situationally amazing, only because of the fact that it depends on what room you're going in. It's a good item. Any item that can give you something great is great, but of course it could also give you something terrible, or even in the worst case scenario, give you a lump of coal. And even then, the lump of coal is not all that terrible, but I do want to say that any, just as a reiteration, anything on the bottom tier does not mean that it's trash. It just means that there's certain situations where it's going to be amazing, or certain situations where it's just going to be completely worthless. And the mystery gift is it ebbs a little bit more towards amazing, because obviously if you open it inside of a devil deal or an angel deal or a shop, you're going to get that something out of that loot table. So it's very, very good, but it just really depends. The value of this item depends on where you use it. So that's why I say situationally amazing. The D-Twanky. Man, oh man, do I want to put this on S rank, but there are times where you're not going to use it. However, I will say that it's better than situationally amazing. Anytime you see the D20, you're going to be taking it. The D20 is so damn good, especially its top tier. It is god tier. It's double S tier when you're in greed mode. For that alone, it should be ranked better than situationally amazing. But the D20 overall, being able to reroll consumables, be able to reroll open chests into regular stuff, combine it with Mom's Key, you got yourself a winning run there, bud. Almost S rank, borderline S rank. D20, I'm comfortable with that staying at A rank for there. The Nail, get on up there, Nail. S rank all the way. It gives you damage. It gives you Stompy, the Stompy effect. And on top of that, it also gives you the Leviathan transformation, and it gives you a Soul Heart. What else could you really want from a spacebar item? The Nail is amazing. S rank all the way, period, point blank. That's where it goes. That's where it stays. Guppy's Paw can be situationally amazing, of course, if you have a lot of red hearts you want to get rid of for the Polaroid invincibility, or if you just want to get rid of all your red hearts, period. It's what it's there for. Of course, it contributes to the Guppy transformation, but other than that, you're not going to be using it for literally anything else. So that's where it's going. The Guppy's Paw can be better than all of these items, especially if you're down to, like, say for example you have 9 lives and you're down to 1 red heart container, but you have Guppy's Paw. Guppy's Paw is going to be better than having any of these. Maybe not better than any of these outside of maybe the Golden Teleporter, depending on where you are in the world on your run. But Guppy's Paw is a very, very good, very strong item if you need to utilize it. If you don't need to utilize it, it's completely worthless, which is why it's down situationally amazing. Now, let's talk about the Tier Detonator, because the Tier Detonator has gotten me into some situations where I do think it is quite useful, especially on that Cricket's Body Jacob's Ladder run that I was talking about earlier. I can't rank it really to anything else other than situationally amazing, because again, much like the Sprinkler, yes, it can be good. Yes, it can be a super duper hardcore hard carry item in the Binding of Isaac. However, again, it's greatly dependent on what your tier effects are. That's the reason why situationally amazing is the only way I can put it there. Sac Altar, Sacrificial Altar, one of the newest items in the game. Of course, it sacrifices a follower and or an orbital and turns it into a devil deal item or 2 devil deal items, depending on how many you have at the time of the use. Situationally amazing at best. It's almost, I would say almost B rank, but I'm going to put it here because it can save you. Giving yourself devil deal items anywhere you want and sacrificing a terrible item like Abel or like, you know, King Baby or anything like that. That alone, giving value to items that don't normally have a lot of value is a very, as I said with the Trinket Smelter, is a very strong part of my criteria for ranking stuff. But there are of course times where you don't want to use Sacrificial Altar, period. Like if you have Dark Bum and you have Rotten Baby, you would never ever use it. So again, going by that logic, going by that sort of comparison, I can't rank it anything other than situationally amazing. And especially considering that the item that you get is random, it could be good, but you could also get the shovel and like the razor blade. So the D8. I love me the D8. It is so good. It's not S rank, but it's definitely better than B rank. The D8 allows you to customize your stats to however you want, as long as you have the full charges. You don't have a whole lot of tiers. Hey, keep rolling till you have a good tiers rate. Your damage sucks. Hey, keep rolling till you have good damage. Your movement speed is awful. Hey, keep rolling till you have good movement speed. The D8 has more power than most of these items on this list, just because of the simple fact it can change your base stats. That alone, giving value to where other values are not present, like if you have too much range, the D8 can redistribute that range into damage. So good. It's not quite as good as the S rank items, but it's certainly way better than situational, because you're going to be using that to fine tune your run and to give you your stats. I love the D8. You should too. Dad's Key, I'm going to go ahead and put this on B rank here. It's certainly not trash, but it's also not top tier. If you want to use your use Dad's Key to get into like early devil doors, or not devil doors, but double lock doors or item rooms of the shop, it can be very viable. Of course, you can also get into the Mega Satan door if you really need it for the achievement. But other than that, that's kind of a niche use. Dad's Key is not terrible. Of course, you can also use it to find secret rooms and super secret rooms if you are sure of where they are. But overall, outside of just opening doors, it doesn't really do a whole lot. So middle of the road is fine with Dad's Key. I like the item, but that's about it. Undefined. Normally, I would be putting this in Situation of the Amazing. However, due to the nerfs a couple years ago with Nicholas completely ruining the undefined loop that you could do in the chest, it's C rank. I hate to do it because, yes, sometimes you can go to the I Am Air room, and more chances often than not, you are going to be taken to a secret room, which is nice, but unlike the Golden Teleporter, you cannot influence where Undefined goes. And of course, there are going to be times where you don't want to go into the I Am Air room at the very beginning of a floor, that sort of thing. So that alone, it can actually screw you pretty badly on your runs as well. So Undefined, it can be good, but I can't rank it. Like, I would not take Undefined over the jump cartridge, over the pony, if I needed movement speed. So C rank it is. It's better than C rank maybe, but yeah. Blue Candle, and let's go ahead and get the red candle here as well. I almost want to put these at S rank, but they're not always a guaranteed item that you're going to take because you may not need them, but they're certainly better than Situationally Amazing, only because of the fact that, of course, they block shots, they deal massive amounts of damage, and they recharge within the same room, and if you get them comboed with a 9-volt, you're going to be having them at a much faster rate. Your DPS is going to go much, much higher, and they can just straight up save you runs. Again, they're almost borderline S rank. They're very good. Use the candles. You've seen what I do with them. You're probably a better player than I am, so use it however you like. But I love the candles. I think everyone knows that. Glass Cannon. I can't really say much about it. It's an item that you never, ever use. It's situationally okay if you want to use it as a Lost, but let's be fair. If you have something like the Book of Shadows or something like that with the Lost, you're not going to take it. You're not going to take Glass Cannon over something like that, so it's not good for any... It's basically not good for any character except the Lost, but that way. The Jar, again, another item that I never, ever use. You know, maybe there's some value in having some shenanigans with, like, say, the school bag and IV bag. Something like that, you could keep a little bit of extra HP for yourself. But overall, it's not an item that's amazing. I don't like it. Box of Spiders, it's not terrible. It's not bad either. I'm going to definitely put that on the B rank. The damage that the spiders do is good enough to warrant a B rank placement. It's certainly not top tier. It's not god tier. But the nice thing about Box of Spiders is that if in a bind you have extra damage there, you get a little bit more value out of your damage stat. And on top of that, it has a very short cooldown. So I like Box of Spiders. Middle of the road, I'm comfortable with that. Kamikaze. So many people are going to want me to put this on Situationally Amazing. Like, oh, you got Pyro. Oh, well, you have to keep in mind that it also is pretty heavily dependent on other bomb upgrades. Kamikaze is almost an item that you never, ever, ever see me pick up. It can be good, I suppose, but overall, it's Kamikaze. TNT Block. I will put this on the B rank again for the same reasons that I gave with the other two bomb items here. TNT Block, it's a single-use bomb that you can plant down. You can actually plant down multiple ones if you have a way to recharge your Space Bra item, like Nun's Habit, something like that. It can be good. I wouldn't use it offensively, though, but if you have a Tenant Rock and you just have an emergency situation where you just don't have any bombs and need one, hey, the TNT Block can help you out. It's not terrible, but also not great. Mom's Bra. Yep. It gives you the Mom Transformation. Yay. Bottle of Pills, I almost want to put this in Situationally Amazing, but of course you know me. You know that I don't take pills at all. For those of you who actually do take pills, you may rank it higher. Again, my own personal taste, my own personal list, I never ever take Mom's Bottle of Pills unless I have PhD or Virgo. And even then, it's not Situationally Amazing because obviously you have no idea what kind of pills you're going to take. There you go. Plan C as well. I just don't use Plan C. If you want to argue, well, it could situationally save you from Isaac, or if you have extra lives, yeah, I guess, but let's be honest, no one's taking Plan C over, like, the D20 or even, like, Doctor's Remote. Well, not for me anyway. Again, I'm speaking for my own tastes here. I'm not going to try to assume what every single Isaac player does in the world, but me personally, I never, ever use Plan C. The glowing hourglass, it can be situationally amazing. It's hard for me to put this down in the trash tier item, but it's also not an item that you're always going to use. So I think that the glowing hourglass down in the situationally amazing reroll tier is a fair spot for it, because yes, you can exploit it to reload your donation machines inside your shop. You can undo damage if you another thing that some people may not know, and this is just a neat little trick that you can do, if you go into a store, you can buy out and reroll the store as much as you want, as long as you have the blue hourglass or the glowing hourglass in your possession. You can actually scroll through, like, hey, I know that champion's belt's coming up, two rerolls now instead of one, so I know not to buy this soul heart before then, you know, that sort of thing. So situationally, the glowing hourglass can be extremely powerful and very good. Overall, though, that's really the only times that you're ever going to see me use it, so yeah. Book of Belial, it's hard for me to put this on the B rank, but it's better than everything on C rank, though. I'm not going to put it on A rank. If it still gave you almost guaranteed devil deal, it would definitely be A rank, maybe even top tier. But right now, with the way it stands, the Book of Belial, it's great for contributing to the Bookworm transformation, doubling your damage, giving you a higher chance to get a horseman. Again, sometimes you a devil deal. There are situations where you can hope that maybe if you have enough damage, the Book of Belial is going to help you. But outside of those desperate situations, I can't really recommend it more than any of the items above it. Placebo. I don't take pills, but what I will say is that situationally, it can be amazing. If you happen to be someone who takes pills, or if you have PhD or Virgo, and you come across, like, say, either a 24-hour, a 40-hour energy pill, or even better, a Balls of Steel pill, Tears Up, that sort of thing, then you can duplicate that as much as you want, up to the cap, of course. And it, in that situation alone, it can be game-breaking, can be very, very strong. Other than that, though, placebo, I mean, outside of those very niche times, I'm not going to mess with placebo. It can be good, usually isn't. TNT Detonator. Again, the remote detonator is okay for the five bombs that it gives you, but other than that, outside of some cute mechanics or cute strategies that you can do with like Sad Bombs and Mr. Mega on like bosses and stuff, it's not something that I really go for at all. Diplopia. I have to say, situationally amazing. This is the very definition of situationally amazing. If you had a dictionary and you looked up the term situationally amazing in Isaac, a picture of Diplopia would be it. This is the granddaddy of them all. The most situationally amazing item, because let's face it, you can go into a boss rush, duplicate everything. You can use it in a multiple item pedestal store. You can use it inside of a multiple item pedestal angel deal, or even an item pedestal room. It's so dang good, but it just depends on where you use it. So Diplopia, excellent, excellent item. If you can use it properly, of course, I'm known for not using it properly because I always forget that I have it. Or I'm like, oh, well, you know, I have so many. Maybe one day I might need these health potions in my Final Fantasy run at the very end of the game. Maybe, maybe not. But it still has value. It's an incredible item. If you can use it properly in the right situation, super good. Breath of Life. After many years and many thousands of hours playing this game, I still don't know how to use it correctly. Yum Heart can be okay. If you need red hearts, sure. If not, it's not that big of a deal. It's what Maggie starts with. It can save you, but I mean, let's be honest. Are you gonna be taking Yum Heart over the like Book of Belial? No, it's not gonna happen. Mom's Box of Stuff, B rank for sure, possibly A rank depending on how lucky you are and if you have what kind of synergies you have. On its own, even on its own, with a 4-room cooldown, Mom's Box of Stuff is really, really good. It gives you the option, it gives you the ability to get better items in the game. So, like, you know, Curved Horn, Goat Hoof, which is not like an incredible item, but it's still, you know, it's stats. You can get raw stats from it, is what I'm trying to say. You can also get resurrection items from it. It's not A rank, but it's certainly not C rank either. I do love myself the Mom's Box of Stuff, if it works out. Most of the time, you get crap trinkets from it. Jar of Flies, get on up there, Jar of Flies. You knew it was coming. A rank for sure. Better than Guppy's Head. I'll fight anyone who wants to take me on that, except outside of you, no, needing Guppy. And speaking of Guppy's Head, I'm going to put Guppy's Head also up here as well. Skip ahead here. Both of these items are very good. They generate attack flies. Of course, the benefit of Guppy's Head is the fact that you get guaranteed flies in every single full charge, whereas there's no full charge at all. There's no charge period on the Jar of Flies, but it's dependent on how many enemies you kill in the room. And chances are you're going to be getting more flies per room than you are going to be getting with a jar of flies than you are going to be getting with Guppy's head. So, but they're both equal in my opinion. I prefer one or the other. Take Guppy's head if you need the Guppy transformation. If not, or if you have like Nun's Habit or something like that, or 9-volt. But if you don't have that, I'll always end up going for jar of flies over Guppy's head, just because of the fact you can spawn 20 flies at once. It's very, very nice. The D7, it's not something you're ever going to use, really. Same with the D12 and the D8. The D10. It's just not great. Sure, sometimes if you get lucky, it can be good, but other than that, I never ever use it. Mega Blast, man, oh man. You talk about hard carry items. I do want to put it on A rank, but the fact of the matter is, if this is down here, I have to look at other items that have similar mechanics, right? You have items that deal direct damage and let's face it, are considered hard carry items. Are you really going to say that Mega is on the same level as the candle items? No. Mega does so much more damage than that. It recharges surprisingly fast if you're good at aiming. And on top of that, it can also persist through floors. So Mega has got to be an S rank item. I mean, just that's just it. It's so good. Does so much damage if you can unlock it. Of course, the downside is that obviously it's on a 12 room cooldown or a 12 charge cooldown. But if you happen to get void and you void it, then of course it becomes a 6 room item cooldown, and it's much better that way. But Mega overall, it's carried runs, it saved your runs, it saved my runs. Very good item, S rank all the way. Brown Nugget. Sure, I suppose. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of the Brown Nugget just because I just don't use it all that often. If you do want to use the Nugget, I mean, it can be okay, I suppose, but it's for me personally. This is just my own personal flavor on it. You know, getting the friendly fly that does damage and it moves and fires at enemies, that sort of thing, it only persists in the current room and it doesn't scale with your damage, so I'd rather have something else. I'd rather the wooden nickel than the brown nugget. Book of the Dizzed. Got to put it up there on A rank. It is very, very good. Of course, if you need orbitals, if you need damaging orbitals, and it gives value in corpses or stuff that you've killed in the room, Book of the Dead is a very strong new item to the game. I like it. It's not quite S rank, but it's certainly better than B rank. Flush. I almost want to say situationally amazing, but I have to go through my brains and figure out exactly how many times have I actually deliberately used Flush in my runs, and not maybe like a handful of times. Maybe on one hand, I've used Flush deliberately to clear out a room. It's not that great. Deck of cards, B rank for sure. Giving yourself some sort of value out of your space bar item is a crucial part in determining its rank on here. And the fact that deck of cards can give you Joker cards, that alone makes it super duper good. I mean, it's not bad at all. It's middle of the road for sure. Only bad thing is that, of course, it does have a longer cooldown for what it does. And, of course, most of the cards you get are probably going to be worthless, but occasionally it can show flashes of greatness, and it could be a very strong item. Mr. Boom, got to be B rank again. I've already talked about the bomb synergies the bomb rankings for the other ones. Same thing applies here with Mr. Boom. The Head of Krampus, man. Now, people are gonna have problems with this one. And I'm putting it at A rank. I almost want to put it at B rank just because of the twirly bird whirl that it can do. And you can't control when that procs. But it does. But Krampus' head does deal good damage. And you can find it almost every run. I mean, you're almost always, if you're adept at finding devil deals, or if you have goat head or something like that, you're going to run into Krampus eventually, and you have a good chance of getting Krampus's head. It can definitely fill the void if you need a hard carry spacebar item in there, or if you just need to add supplemental damage to your run, but it's not S rank. I cannot put Krampus's head on the same tier as Mega. It's hard for me to even put it on the same tier as Guppy's head or even the D20, but let's be honest, it is better than most of the B rank items anyway, outside of maybe the exception of Doctor's Remote if we're talking one-to-one direct damage, but Head of Krampus is not bad. It's borderline B rank for me, but I will put it at A rank because I think that's fair. Dead Sea Trolls, it's called that for a reason. Now, I'm going to assume this is regular Butterbean. Butterbean, I'm also going to be putting at C rank. These are just items that, if you want to use them, use at your own risk. Now, Wait What, on the other hand, Wait What is absolutely an A-tier item. I love Wait What. It can reroll stuff. It can open up It can open up secret rooms, super secret rooms. It can destroy tinted rocks. It can even be used to deal damage, and you can use it to take donations out of the donation machine. On top of that, it has a constantly recharging charge, which is not something that a whole lot of other items can say. So I love Wait What. It's not S tier, but it's almost S tier, but put it on A because of the short cooldown, the amount of damage that you get, and the amount of utility that you can use it for. It's very good. The nice thing about Butterbean, of course, actually the best thing about Butterbean is that it can turn into Wait What just by picking it up and putting it down. That's something else that we found out not that long ago. Portable slot. As soon as you find me someone who uses this item on the consistent level, like, let me know. Same thing goes for the Razor Blade. You get damage from your HP, I suppose, but it's not even situational. I can't recommend it. Rare card. It's almost A rank. I am going to put it on B rank, however, because again, if we're going along the lines of there's some items that we may not have any use for, but does that mean it's trash? No. The eternal or the prayer card gives you a half eternal heart. Can be extremely good, especially if you have a room where there's a bunch of full charges in there and you already have some eternal hearts. You can give yourself essentially almost unlimited HP as long as you have a full charge. So that alone puts it in B rank. It's not as good as the others, but it's certainly not trash either. Pandora's Box. Again, same lines with Diplopia. Wherever you use it, on what floor you ever go for, you can't really rank it at anything else. It could be good. It's as good as you want it to be. Just learn what it does on all the individual floors. The Bean. Again, if you can find someone who purposely uses the Bean for what it's supposed to do, let me know. Same thing goes for Telepathy for Dummies. It contributes to the Bookworm transformation, but I don't know anyone who uses it deliberately. Whenever I see the Telepathy for Dummies or any of the books that are located in the C tier, I'm always looking at the first chance of getting rid of my space bar item for something better. Tammy's freaking head. Man, oh man. Again, along the same lines of the sprinkler, I gotta put Tammy's head down here. Situationally amazing. Now, let me say this. I've gone on record to say, and I stand by this, Tammy's head in certain situations is the ultimate hard carry item in the game, period. There is no other item that carries you harder than Tammy's Head Brimstone. There's almost no denying it. But Tammy's Head by itself, assuming that you just have base Isaac tiers, is not that great. It's good because you get the extra shots, of course, and you can use it whenever you want. It only has a one room cooldown, especially one that recharges with the 9-volt or if you have like Nun's Habit, something like that. But given the right circumstance, along the same lines of the sprinklers, Tammy's head can be the ultimate hard carry item in the game, period. I like Tammy's head. It's not a bad item. And again, none of these items down here are bad. They're just situational. Magic Fingers, on the other hand, is a bad item. I mean, if you have 99 cents and you want to use it on Blue Baby, sure. But other than that, I don't like it. Book of Shadows. Again, talking about almost A rank. In fact, I am going to put the Book of Shadows on A rank here. A rank, it essentially, Book of Shadows is along the same lines of the Unicorn, or My Little Unicorn. Can be great with orbitals. Of course, if you need to be able to get in and out of curse rooms for free, you have extra ways to give yourself full charges, good. It contributes to the Bookworm transformation, has a relatively short cooldown. The only thing that is a negative against it is that the Book of Shadows shield, compared to other damage invincibility shields or active damage mitigation shields, is very, very short. The duration does not last long at all. But that's not enough for me to knock that down to B tier. I like the Book of Shadows. I've used it many times. It can be an absolute game breaker if you have Sack Dagger. That alone right there, Book of Shadows, A rank, period. Mom's Pad. It's gross. The Omega Penny, or the Crooked Penny. Get on over here. I consider it almost like a reroll item. It's a 50-50. Sometimes you can double, sometimes you can't. When you double over and over again, it feels so good. It feels like you are God of the Isaac world. And then it will take all the items and turn it into a penny. So, situationally amazing. If you're lucky, it's a money generator at its worst. But it's better than these items over here, in my opinion. Moving Box. People are going to yell at me if I put this in C rank, so I'll just say situationally amazing. I think we all know my stance on Moving Box. That's all I'm going to say. Now, the whole reason. This is the whole reason why I'm re-recording this video. in light of the most recent discovery, which I'm very proud to say, and I'm flattered and honored and happy that I finally discovered something in my name that no one else has ever known about it. Mr. Me. Mr. Me can get you out of boss rush. Now, since that video was recorded, and since this video was recorded, it has been confirmed that Mr. Me cannot get you into boss rush. Somebody on Reddit tested this, and I apologize for not remembering your name, but someone on Reddit tested this whenever the Reddit thread came out that I discovered that Mr. Me can get you out of boss rush. It cannot get you into boss rush, and that was confirmed. So, but that being said, Mr. Me has got to be S rank, absolutely S rank. There's no denying it. You talk about items that give you value. You talk about items that can create other options for you. Mr. Me, if you need a bomb, it's a bomb. If you need a key, it's a key. If you need to get out of boss rush, it acts as a teleportation card, kind of. If you want unlimited money and you want to steal stuff from the store, you can do that. If you want a devil deal, you can do that. You can even game the system with double item pedestals if you're quick enough. Mr. Me is absolutely one of the most, if not the most versatile item in all of the Binding of Isaac. It cannot be denied that the value you get from Mr. Me is so good. And you can use it as a follower if you need extra damage. I mean, you can't say enough about the item. What else can it do? You know, maybe there's other undiscovered powers that Mr. Me has, but for those of you who may not be a regular watcher of mine, you don't know what the situation is. Very recently on one of my latest Eden runs, I discovered on a whim that Mr. Me can actually get you out of boss rush if you remember where the location of the entrance was coming in from Mom's room. And I tested it out and I was blown away. It was the most genuine surprise reaction I think I've ever had on the microphone, period. And it was confirmed later on that no one knew about this. It wasn't in the wiki, it wasn't on Platinum Guide, Luke didn't know about it, nobody knew about this, Reddit didn't know about it either. So I take pride in knowing that I'm the first to discover it. Now I'm sharing that info with you, and I'm also sharing the information that the fact that Mr. Me is a God tier, S tier item, period. It is so good. It's anything that you want it to be in the game. There is literally no other item that can tell you that has that much value as much as Mr. Me. Compost. Compost is almost S tier. Almost S tier. The only reason why I'm not putting it on S tier is because if there's certain situations where you don't need it, then it's not that great. Of course, it gives you one spider, it gives you one fly, depending on what consumables are on the ground or what open chests are on the ground. But where the strength of compost lies is, of course, its ability to double the amount of active spiders and active flies. Basically because of the fact, if you have Guppy, or if you have the Mulligan, or if you have Hive Mind, anything like that, or let's say you also have Jar of Flies and you've got Backpack, something like that, compost can be extremely powerful, and it can be a hard carry item. I can't rank it on S rank though, just because it does start out at zero. You need to have the base value. You need to have the base amount of flies and spiders before you really get value out of it. It's still an excellent item. I like compost. Thank you for telling me that I finally need to use it correctly, and I'm glad that I did. Monstro's tooth. It's not good. Monstro can hit you. He frequently misses the target that you're trying to destroy. It's Monstro's tooth. Now, the potato peeler. I'm going to put this one down. It's situationally amazing, and this is the reason why. There are going to be times where you do not need an orbital, and you don't necessarily want to get rid of your red hearts. So if you're saving them for a devil deal or something like that, then yeah, you don't want to be using potato peeler. It is nice to give yourself an orbital, and of course the associated damage upgrade that comes with it. But there are times where it has absolutely no value. Again, along the same lines of the D4 and the D100, the potato peeler, I like the concept as an item. I think it's a good item. It's definitely nice to have the option to do so. But given the fact that there is the option to use it, there's also the equal amount of opportunities that you don't want to use it because you don't want to lose the red hearts. You don't necessarily need the orbital. So I'm a big fan of the potato peeler, but in this situation, I have to put it situationally amazing. It's a good item, though. Just get that out of the way. It's a good item. Void, you know where this is going. S rank for sure. It can be any item in the game that you want it to be for the space bar. It's talking about giving value to other items that do not have value. If you get Able, Void can turn Able into something useful instead of being a big waste of space. Void is amazing. You could turn it to the D20. You could turn it to the Book of Secrets. You could turn it into whatever you want. Void is just that good. And you can Void Mega in order to have a 6-room Mega Head Blast or Mega Blast, whatever you want to call it, instead of 12. Void is an absolutely outstanding item, if not the best spacebar item in the game, period, just because of how much it does. And it can you can morph it and evolve it to however you like. I love Void. It's amazing that they made that item work for how it is. Void is incredible. The remote, it can save runs, but overall, I never, ever, ever use it, especially on the Eden Street, because you can get turned into the Forsaken, or the Lost. You can get turned into the Forgotten, the Keeper. You don't want to do that. You can also turn into Judas, or you can turn into Apollyon, or even Azazel. It's not an item that I use, and I don't recommend using it, unless you're just crazy. Friend Ball, it's Friend Ball. The only thing that's nice about it is, of course, that it can remove a champion out of your way, or you can use it defensively like I did in that one episode, but other than that, it's not the greatest. Same thing goes for Boomerang. I have yet to find a good use of the Boomerang outside of maybe getting a hard-to-reach chest or an out-of-reach full charge, something like that, but it's not a good item. It does freeze enemies on contact and has a low cooldown, so that is good, but it doesn't deal hardly any damage, I don't think. In fact, I don't even know if it deals any damage. But overall, it's just not an item that you're really going to be using at all. I mean, it's not the greatest. Does it deal damage? I don't think it does deal. I'm pretty sure it doesn't deal damage. Anyway. The D Infinity, again, same thing along the lines with the D100 and the D4. I do like the D Infinity, but it can also be completely worthless here. It's got, I've already explained the reroll items here. The scissors. Not a fan of the scissors. They can be good, I guess, in very, very, very niche situations. But let's be honest, you're not picking up the scissors over anything else above it. At least I'm not anyway. Again, I'm not. I need to make sure I refocus this on me. I'm not using it over anything else. Let's put it that way. Same thing goes for the Giga Bean. The Giga Bean can be okay. It can open up secret rooms. It can open up rocks if you get lucky enough for the fissures to open it. But other than that, it's a forgettable item. Spider Butt, I really want to put this on the B rank. I really, really do, but Spider Butt doesn't do a whole lot of damage, and the slowing effect doesn't really last that long. I'm sorry, Spider Butt fans. I like your Spider Butts, and I like me some Spider Butts, but there's just other better items out there, and I usually get rid of it for the first chance I see for any B rank item or above. Data Miner, I still don't know what this thing does, other than just Fs everything up, as made by the description. The Book of Sin, get on up there, A rank for sure, possibly even S rank. I can't put it on S rank though, but the Book of Sin is an incredible item. Only 4-room cooldown, it can give you consumables, it can give you HP, it can give you tarot cards, I mean anything that you want, the Book of Sin can do that. It is an absolute amazing item. It's very cheap to find in the Deal with the Devil, it contributes, and you can find it in the library as well. It's very, very common to see on any given run, which is the reason why I like it better than most of the other books out there, except maybe the Satanic Bible, which I'm going to also put on the A rank, possibly S rank. This one is tough because giving yourself the ability to have a black heart is good, and the S, and you can argue that the S ranks, if you are a follower of mine, you know what black heart bombing is. Giving yourself a black soul heart is extremely powerful. It gives you the Necronomicon style or dry baby style damage whenever you exhaust the black soul heart, or you can just use it as a soul heart generator. You don't have to go for black heart bombing. Satanic Bible, you know, would I take? I have to ask myself this question. Would I take Satanic Bible over Book of Shadows? Yes. Would I take it over the Book of Sin? Yes. Would I take it over the Book of Revelations? Yes. All because of the way that the Black Soul Hearts operate. So, given that criteria, it also goes very well with Void. It's a solid item. Top tier. You see Satanic Bible. You pick it up. It's that good. Unicorn Stump. Unicorn Stump, definitely A tier, possibly even S tier. It's better than Situationally Amazing. If you have an Orbital, it can almost be S tier, especially if you have Sack Dagger, then it becomes S tier. But it really comes down to how you use it, and are you expecting to get an Orbital, or are you going to be using it just for, you know, if you want to use it for like Demon Judgments or Blood Banks, that sort of thing. The Unicorn Stump is a great item because of the low cooldown. The only bad thing is, of course, you can't fire while it's active, and you also don't deal damage with it. So don't take the Unicorn Stump unless you have an Orbital, really. Or if you're just going to use it to get in and out of curse rooms, something like that, then sure. Or if you want to go over spikes. The Holy Bible. Holy Bible, I'm going to put it on B rank only because of the fact that, yes, you can use it against Mom. You can use it against Mom's Heart. It gives you flying for sure. I put it on par with the jump cartridge because I frequently relate these two together because they both have somewhat of a, more so the jump cartridge, than, less so than the Bible, but they have active damage mitigation. If you have flying or if you can jump around stuff, you get those iframes. For me personally, it's back and forth. I could take either the Bible or the jump cartridge. It really just depends on how my run is looking, but I can't rank the Bible on the same level as anything above it. So the Bible is not a bad item though. Now, let's talk about the Dull Razor. Dull Razor, it's hard for me to rank this anywhere because there are situations, especially if you have something like Gimpy, if you have Bloody Lust, or really anything that requires you to take damage. Another good one is Varicose Veins, which is one that a lot of people don't really think about, including myself. But the Dull Razor can be extremely good, sort of along the same lines as Blood Rites, except I would say Dull Razor is much more beneficial than Blood Rites is, just because you get more than just damage out of it. So I do like the Dull Razor. I can't rank it anywhere, though, just because it can be good, but it can also be completely just worthless. I like the Dull Razor, though. It's a great concept for an item as well. Now, pause. Got to get up there again with the Unicorn Stump, almost S rank. Almost S rank. The only reason why I'm not putting it on S rank is because, much like the Unicorn Stump, it is heavily, heavily dependent on if you have an orbital or if you have a follower like Daddy Longlegs, somewhere like that, that deals passive damage that is separate from Isaac. It can be extremely good, but it's not god tier. It's almost god tier. If you have a good orbital, however, it's definitely worth it, and it becomes god tier. Again, same thing, same criteria with the Unicorn Stump. I'm almost over an hour, so I'm going to try to wrap this one up in a hurry. Metronome, I like Metronome. It's goofy, it's wacky, but you never know what you're going to get out of it. It can be good. It can be amazing, actually, but you can also get blown up and kill yourself by getting Plan C. The D-Sizzle. Much like the D8 and the D20, I cannot rank it any higher than this, but I also can't rank it lower. The D6 is almost always going to be good. There are very few situations where I cannot fathom the idea of skipping the D6 over possessing any of these items below it. I really cannot. Even compared to the D20 and the D8, the D6 is just better, in my opinion. Being able to reroll item pedestals, being able to reroll stores, I mean, anything you want. The D6, it gives you more options. It's almost S tier. I'm not going to put it on S tier, though, just because of the fact that it's the same criteria I use with the D20 and the D8. All of those can be S tier. It just depends on what you get. You can also get basically nothing, so. Shoop the Whoop! Almost S tier as well. I love me some Shoop. Everyone knows I love Shoop. Much along the same lines of Crack the Sky, Shoop the Whoop is an amazing item. It's one of the best items you're not using. It's so common to see. You can even see it multiple times on the same run, even if you've seen it once. So, I like Shoop because it does good damage. It's an on-use every other room Brimstone, or if you have 9-volt, it's every room Brimstone. It is so good. Boss killer, hard carry item, excellent item. I love me some Shoop. The Notched Axe. If you want to, you could probably argue, much like Minecrafter, you could probably argue it might be B tier, but I'm not putting it up there. It can be nice if you don't have the bombs or if you don't have the stompy effect, but overall, it's cumbersome to use and it also stops you from attacking, so it's not a great item. The Pinking Shears, again, along the same lines with Crack the Sky, Pinking Shears can be a hard carry item. It can absolutely crush any boss in the game. If you're doing boss rush and you have the Pinking Shears, your smile is from ear to ear because you're going to get multiple torsos doing massive amounts of damage. I love it. I absolutely adore the Pinking Shears. One of those items that really surprised me because I was like, ooh, this item sucks. And then I realized how much damage it actually does after someone in the mosh pit told me that, by the way, this is many, many, many years ago. But someone in the mosh pit said, you know, how come you're not using the Pinking Shears? I was like, oh, it just gives you flying. They're like, no. The torso does massive amounts of damage. I was like, get out of here. And then I finally used it. I was like, oh, yeah, Pinking Shears are amazing. Necronomicon, I almost want to put it on C tier, but I'm not going to. If you want to use it for an AoE damage dealer, you can. Is the Necronomicon as bad as Anarchist Cookbook? No, but it's at the very bottom of the B tier. Let's put it that way. I mean, if you need AoE damage, it can be good. And yes, it does contribute to the Bookworm transformation. But most of the time, you either start with it. It can show up in an item room or a devil deal. And whenever you see it, you're just kind of bummed, you know? So any item that makes you do that can't be considered top tier. Sharp Straw. It's an item that I don't really use all that much. I mean, if I want to, if I'm going with that explanation of the Necronomicon, I have to put the Sharp Straw there as well. If you can use it properly, it can be good. It's not an item that deals a ton of damage, however, but it is nice that it does have a very low cooldown. If in a bind, it can help you, but again, like the Necronomicon, if you need it, it's there, but it's not. It's at the bottom of the B rank. Hourglass, let's be honest, I don't know anyone who uses the Hourglass as it's intended. You'd rather have Spider Bite. Isaac's Tears. Now, Isaac's Tears, I cannot equate Isaac's Tears to Tammy's Head or the Sprinkler. I just can't. I don't use Isaac's Tears that much. Even if you have tier effects, it doesn't always duplicate certain tier effects in that you currently possess. So it is nice that you can use it multiple times, of course. But again, talking about the cumbersomeness of the use, having to break up the flow of combat, having to stop your firing so you can use it, it's not a fun item to use. And generally speaking, whenever I see it, I'm ready to replace it. Kidney Bean, it gives you AoE charm. Yay. Eden's Soul, gotta be situational. Again, much like the Pandora's Box, much like the Mystery Gift here and Sacrificial Altar, all of these items here you can use anywhere you need to, and they will turn into something that could be good. Most of the time are good, but sometimes can be bad. Situational is the only way I can put them. Again, to reiterate, these items down here do not mean they're the bottom of the barrel. It just means that they're amazing items in their own right, given the proper situation. I want to keep reiterating that, even though I know people aren't going to watch the entire video and they're going to go complain about it on Reddit. The Teleporter, got to put it on B rank here. Again, if you need to get out of boss rush, or if you need to get out of a challenge room, you can use it. The only cautionary thing that I will say about the Teleporter, of course, is the fact that you can be taken to the IM error room, and that could completely screw your run. Be careful. The D-Wizzle. I gotta put it on A tier. I love me the D1. The D1 will duplicate anything on the ground other than a Yara rune. It's completely broken in greed mode if you have a 2 of diamonds on the ground. It's completely broken in regular mode if you have a 2 of diamonds on the ground. It is just that darn good. If you know how to manipulate what's on the ground, you can give yourself unlimited broken items. It is an absolutely top tier item. Almost S, but I gotta keep it with the other die. A rank for sure. The Shovel. You can use it to skip floors or possibly find crawl spaces, I guess. But there's no way I can say the Shovel is on the same rank as like the Book of Belial. I mean, if it works out, sure, but if not, it usually doesn't. Little Delirium, regular Delirium, I should say, just get over here. It's, you summon random bosses and they usually don't help you. And if you summon Hush, the screen becomes a giant cluster truck. So the Coupon, I love me some Coupon. Get on up there, A rank for sure. Guaranteed half price item. Guaranteed free deals with the devil items that if you don't want to use your HP. It can give you one random free item in the store. And again, much along the lines of the D1, if you know how to manipulate anything that's on the ground, existing item pedestals or something on the consumable level, it can get you exactly what you want. The Coupon is an amazing new item in the game that's been out for a little while now. I like the Coupon, definitely A rank. Mama Mega, almost S rank. I'm gonna put her on A rank, however, but Mama Mega is great. She essentially gives you a free level, a free boss kill, and free entrance into the boss rush if you want it. What can you say about Mama Mega? The worst thing about her is that it pauses the game and it does a white flash. That's about it. Other than that, Mama Mega is very, very, very common to see in the store, and she can give you outs where they usually wouldn't exist. She gets you secret rooms, she gets you super secret rooms, she destroys mushrooms, pots, blood clots, anything that you want. Mama Mega does that and more. I love me some Mama Mega. Conquest Pony, I gotta put it same tier as the regular pony. I do like it because obviously you get the Crack the Sky effect, but it's all predicated on you A, finding Conquest, and B, needing something that isn't better than the pony. So I can't put it on A rank. It's almost A rank. Same thing goes with the pony, but I got to put it in B. And last but not least, Mom's Box of Friends. I'm going to put situationally amazing because obviously I can't think of her name now for some odd reason. Why can I not think of her name? You know the Isaac character I'm talking about. if you start as her, and you, or if you have like a bunch of, if you have Incubus, Lilith, that's who I'm thinking of. I can't believe I have space on that. If you're starting as Lilith, of course, Mom's Box of Friends becomes one of the most, if not the most amazing item in the game, especially for greed mode. But even if you're not Lilith, it still can be very useful. Overall, though, is it really an item that you're going to be wanting, like, oh man, I hope I get Mom's Box of Friends? Probably not. I will also mention, of course, there's the absence of the school bag. The reason why the backpack or the school bag was not included on this list is because A, Odlin didn't put it on here, and B, I don't really think that it belongs here just because it doesn't do anything. It just gives you an extra slot, so that's the reason why it was omitted. So I'm going to wrap it up there, though. This video ended up going over an hour anyway because, woo, I hate my voice, I guess. But yeah. That is going to do it for my tier list of the space bar items. A special shout out to tiermaker.com for providing this platform to do it on, and also to Odlin, who went through the painstaking process of importing all of the space bar items in the game into the website and making it public for you all guys and girls to use, which again, I'll be leaving a link down below where you can create your own space bar items here in the tiermaker website. Thank you for watching. I know that it's going to bring a lot of discussion. I love those discussions. Keep on doing it in the comment section. Keep on liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.